Eritrea's foreign policy, as an extension of its internal policy, was and still is based on preserving its national interest for mutual respect and cooperation, working in the interests of peace and stability in the region and in the world, and enhancing cooperation in all areas with all governments and peoples. In a nutshell, Eritrea's foreign policy is that of peace and non-alignment based on independence and national interest.
You know where we come from. We have a policy, and I believe that's appropriate for any one nation, any one government to define its foreign policy parameters. We believe that we can only survive and live in a safe neighborhood. A safe neighborhood for everyone. I don't think it's unique for Eritrea, but it's also a prerequisite for any country, any nation to survive. We need to have a safe neighborhood. We've gone a long way to achieve our independence. Eritrea is a young nation. We have learned it the hard way that we can only survive, and anybody else for that matter. It's not a matter of size, it's not a matter of wealth or strength. It's a prerequisite in a civilized world where we need safe neighborhood.
As an independent and sovereign member of the international community, Eritrea became a member of regional and international organizations soon after independence and upheld international laws and charters, playing its active role within the international community and its organizations.
I think in the first place, to survive in the region as a small nation, I think we need an environment of regional peace and stability. I think there is consensus both here and within among the countries in the region that there are cultural affinities, there is geographic proximity, there are complementary economies.
It goes back again and again to a safe neighborhood where we live peacefully with our neighbors. And we have to be actively involved. We can't be passive about what happens in our neighborhood. It's not our job to do things on behalf of others, but we need to do things with our neighbors so that we safely create an environment conducive for all of us to live peacefully.
It set priorities in this regard for reaching its regional and international objectives via initially establishing relations with all countries, regardless of their political and economic systems, solely based on independence, respect of territorial integrity and national dignity, non-aggression, non-interference in internal affairs, equality and mutual interest. And by doing so, Eritrea managed to bring international acclaim from good-willing heads of state and nations from all over the world.
Thank you.
has any right to intervene into the internal affairs of every country, allowing majority or the population to participate in the politics of every country. And that's a very serious matter for African countries, and we seriously consider that as part of the software we need to develop. But that should not be polarizing society. I mean, you cannot polarize society on religious grounds. You cannot polarize society on tribal and clan grounds. We have so many examples in Africa. It's camouflaged by what people call democracy, and Europeans and Americans would like to talk about democracy in Africa as a way of dividing and weakening undeveloped communities. I mean, the socio-economic transformation is very important. Unless you live at a higher level of assimilation, if you live in a tribal society and you go for democracy in a tribal society, you get divided into 100 political parties, and vertical polarization is not good at all.
Giving top priority to developing economic and cultural cooperation with all countries of the world, therefore, so as to accelerate its own country's economic and social development, Eritrea has gone as far as east is from the west to build friendship with all peoples, regardless of historical and cultural difference, solely based on universal brotherhood, equality, peace, and understanding.
African countries will have to do a lot in this regard. They will have to go so many steps ahead, create a situation where they build nations, they get rid of all these divisive or divisive forces in society, come to an awareness where people will be educated to have the responsibility to assume in a country, and the political institutions you develop in a country are also very important in terms of development and investment.